Hi guys, my name is Harvansh, and in my last video you have seen that how to install Symantec Endpoint Protection Manager. That was the primary server. So now I'm going to show you how to install the secondary site for Symantec Manager. That site will be used as a failover, and like why we needed it. We need it because if the one Symantec server is goes down, so another Symantec server will be up, and through that we can all the client will move there and our infrastructure will not be impacted. So let's start this video how we can install the secondary site. So here is my setup, and right click, run as an administrator. The setup will run. It will be like a similar we installed in my last video. So install the Symantec Endpoint Protection Manager. Click here. Setup will start now. So here is the option like install the management server and console. Click here, accept the license, click on next. So it asking where you want to install it, whether on C drive or D drive or wherever. Just click and change the path. Okay. So I set up the path to D drive. So my setup will goes to D drive. It will not install on C drive. Now click on next. Here is ready to install. Click on next and setup will start now. The new file are copying. So once the file will copy, installation will start, and after this video I will make another videos to about the console overview and the policies, client management and all the things. So step by step I will create the videos. If you guys want to give me any feedback, you can comment on my video and send me the email, or if you like that video, so let me know. And if anything you want, like any specific video about Symantec, any policies or anything whatever comes in your mind, or if you want to explain me any specific topic in brief, I will create the video and will share with you. We are waiting now. Setup will start. Have to wait few more seconds. Okay, so now my first task is done. Install the management server and console. That is done. Now here is a configure the management server. So one step is done. Now we are on second step. Click next and we'll wait. Management server configuration wizard. So as we seen in the last video, we was having that three option: default, configuration, installation fewer than 500. So if we select this option, it will take use and the updated database fewer than 500. Anyway, I am on lab, but I want to show you how to install the Symantec Manager with the SQL database. So let me select the custom configuration for the new installation. Click on next. And here is a three option: installed my first site. So this option I was used in my first video because that time I was installing primary Symantec, but now my primary Symantec is ready and I am the stage to install the secondary site. So this option I will not take. Let's check the second option: install the additionally management server that you configure the file over the load balancing. But this option will use install and the additional management server to end the existing site. So if already you are having the site and you want to install your console there, so in that case it will work. But now here is the third option: install and the additional site. So I will use this option because when I will use this option, it will install the Symantec Manager as a secondary and it will report it to the primary site. Click next. So here is the replication server. So here is the screen. Here will filled about our the old Symantec, first Symantec. So this is the my first Symantec where is my first primary server got installed, and now I am installing the secondary site. So in this page will give our primary server details. So replication server, Okay, let's check the host name. I will do the ping for my PIM. So this is my primary server hostname. Okay, here is the port that will communicate, and here will give the password that we are using in Symantec console login. As I have not created any other account in my Symantec manager, so that's why I am using admin account. So here is the replicate client package live update content between the side to side. If we want to select it, we can select it. If you want to replicate, so most of the scenario it's not needed. If you want, you can select it. Now click on next. So it will check your authentication. It's the like a warning security for signatures, public key. Just select it. Yes. Now we are on the second page. So it's showing like site SCPM2. So this is the secondary site, and the port detail, server name, everything is here. If you want to change any port, you can change it. If not, just click on next. Okay, so it's asking select the database, default database, MDD database it will create, or if we are having SQL database, we'll select this. As we already installed our SQL database here, so I'm going to select database. No need to select this, we'll configure it later for like a backup, reindexing, that I will show in the any other video. Click on next. Now again is the screen. Do you want to create Symantec endpoint protection database or use the existing? So create a new database or use in the existing database. So use an existing database we select when my already Symantec installed, and I uninstall the my console and database is already there in SQL. In that scenario we are selecting the second. First, as I needed the new database, I will select the create a new database. Okay, click on next. So here is a window where it will ask for the some authentications. I have my SQL authentication. Okay, I have my SA account. I will keep my SA account. Better to use your SA account only. That will be good for connectivity. Even you can use the, if you don't have the SA account, you can use the Windows authentication and give your Windows authentication. But your account should having admin privileges, sysadmin in the database, or else it will fail to create your SEPM database. So here is it asking for the SQL client. Okay, let's see where it is. D drive program file. Tools bin and the BCN. Okay, let me copy this and paste it here. Let me connect. So sometime if it is failed, you can back and again forward, try it. If your authentication is accessible, it will work. If not, it will fail. Even you can try with your other account also, SA you can use it, or your Windows authentication you can use it. Okay, fine. So it's not showing any error. And the other thing, let's see, this is the new database creation. CM database name will be SAM5. If you want to change your database name also, you can change it. If not, let it be. So by default, Symantec will create SAM5 name database. And here I am giving the password. Set. And guys, this password should not have any special character, or else it will fail. Click on next. Okay, it's taken. Now it's the live update. I don't want to run my live update now. And here is a partner email ID, customer ID, partner website, not required. Click on next. Here is the send. Here is a send anonymous data to Symantec. No, I don't want to send any details to Symantec. Click on next. Now it start creating the database and automatically it will add to my primary database, that is here. Better to log off and close this, or else it will be creating a problem to add as a secondary site. So in my last video, that was taking almost the 20 minutes because I was explaining to some other things also, and here it will be done soon. It will not take much time. So after installing this, I will create videos about the Symantec console overview, their features, what we can do, what we can't do it, or how to use the policy, firewall policy, etc, etc, all the things. I will create the one by one videos, and guys, if you like it, so please let me know, comment, and if you want any other videos related to Symantec, comment me or drop me an email. You want any other video, anything related to the Symantec or any issues you are facing, you can contact me. Getting installed. So guys, this channel I created for the people who are struggling to learn Symantec, and as my lot of friends raised this concern, like how much we need some videos to understand the Symantec, how it working, the features, how we can use it. So when I explained to so many people, and do you know the peoples are, more peoples are coming to you, so each and every person you can sit and explain. So better to go with the videos. So that's why I start creating these videos, so people come to know, and I can help to more and more people to be cover up their technology. Okay guys, so it installed, and now it says select option, launch the Symantec configuration manager. Okay, yes, I want. Now click on finish. So now my Symantec manager is installed without any issues, and the console will launch automatically. Will wait for a few minutes because it's a first time installation, and it will take some time to launch the console. We'll wait for a few seconds, it will come. Okay, so it start loading. Will wait until it will not open. Just want to show you guys after installation how it will looks. It's taking, I think, more time, but we can't do anything, we have to wait until this console will open. Come on. Okay, yeah, finally it come, and my username will be the admin and giving the password. Click on login. And parallelly, I will log in my primary Symantec Manager also. I will show you how it will looks like in primary Symantec Manager. Okay, so admin. Also, okay, so this is my primary server that we installed last time. And if you want to see where is your secondary site, go to admin tab. Admin tab, click on servers. So here you can see in it the remote site. It's created with the site name SEPM. And this is the local site SEPM, and this is the SEPM 2. So here you can see in it, that is the site name, database name, and the replication partner. The same way for the remote site, local site will be SEPM2, and the replication partner is this. Okay guys, so it's done. And here in the same way we can go to the secondary site and we can check whether my replication partner is created or not. Go to admin and servers, and here is, you can see in it, now we successfully added our remote site. Okay guys, thank you watching for this video. I hope you like it. Thanks again.